Brothers and sisters, as we prepare ourselves for the Holy Mass, please be reminded of the following. 1. Let's observe the 1-hour Eucharistic fast, so we can be ready to receive our Lord in the Holy Eucharist. Please do not eat any food an hour before the Mass. Drinking water is allowed. 2. Let us honor and respect our Lord in the Eucharist. Please do not eat during the Mass. 3. Let us show decency and honor to God by dressing appropriately for Mass. 4. To observe solemnity of the Holy Mass, please turn off your mobile phones or put them on silent mode. 5. Let us show our love for God by participating actively in the Holy Mass. Let us sing, respond, listen, and pray during appropriate times. 6. Before receiving Holy Communion, take time to examine your conscience and pray. Please do not receive communion if you know you are in a state of mortal sin. 7. Let us take time to be still and savor God's presence during the Mass, which is the highest form of worship.
Kingdom here on earth. If we use
our talents for the spread of Christ's gospel and for the benefit of our brothers and sisters, then we have profitably invested them, proving ourselves trustworthy servants of the Lord. Our priest, presider for this Eucharistic celebration, is Reverend Father Bob Buenconsejo, S.J. Let us all stand and greet our Mass celebrant, and let us glorify the Lord by singing the entrance song.
Here in this time, here in this place, here we are standing face to face. Here in our hearts, here in our lives, our God is here. Here we become what we receive. Here in this Eucharistic feast, we are His body, living as one. Our God is here. And we cry, holy, holy, holy are You. We cry, holy, holy, holy and true. Amen, we do believe our God is here. Body living as one, our God is here, and we cry, holy, holy, holy are You. We cry, holy, holy, holy and true. Amen. We do believe our God is here.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My sisters and brothers, to prepare ourselves for the celebration of the Word and the Eucharist, let us ask the Lord to forgive us for our sins, our lack of sensitivity to the poor, and our lack of the use of the gifts that God has bestowed on us for the service of the kingdom. Together we say, I confess
to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son,
Amen. Please be seated for the liturgy of the word. The book of Proverbs, a collection of wise sayings, ends with a hymn in praise of the ideal mother and wife. The inspired author pictures the ideal woman as one who uses her talents in the service of her family, of the poor. The first reading.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. When one finds a worthy wife, her value is far beyond pearls. Her husband, entrusting his heart to her, has unfailing prize. She brings him good and not evil all the days of her life. She obtains wool and flax and works with loving hands. She puts her hands to the distaff, and her fingers ply the spindle. She reaches out her hands to the poor, and extends her arms to the needy. Charm is deceptive, and beauty fleeting. The one and the woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her a reward for her labors, and let her works praise her at the city gates. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Blessed are you who fear the Lord, who walk in his ways. For you shall eat the fruit of your handiwork. Blessed shall you be and favored.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Your wife shall be like a fruitful vine in the recesses of your home. Your children like olive plants around your table.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Behold, thus is the man blessed who fears the Lord. The Lord bless you from Zion. May you see the prosperity of Jerusalem all the days of your life.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord. The Apostle Paul reiterates the need to stay alert of the coming of the Lord, all children of the light. We must immerse in works that prepare us for our encounter with the Lord. The second reading.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Concerning times and seasons, brothers and sisters, you have no need for anything to be written to you. For you yourself know very well that the day of the Lord will come, like a thief at the night. When people are saying peace and security, then sudden disaster comes upon them, like labor pains upon a pregnant woman, and they will not escape. But you, brothers and sisters, are not in darkness, for that day to overtake you like a thief, for all of you are children of the light and children of the day. We are not of the night or of darkness. Therefore, let us not sleep as the rest do, but let us stay alert and sober. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please rise for the proclamation of the Holy Gospel. Remain in me as I remain in you, says the Lord. Whoever remains in me bears much fruit. And with your spirit. Glory to you, O Lord.
A man going on a journey called in his servants and entrusted his possessions to them. To one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, to a third 1, to each according to his ability. Then he went away. Immediately the one who received 5 talents went and traded with them and made another 5. Likewise, the one who received 2 made another 2. But the man who received 1 went off and dug a hole in the ground and buried his master's money. After a long time, the master of those servants came back and settled accounts with them. The one who had received 5 talents came forward, begging the additional 5. He said, "Master, you gave me 5 talents. See, I have made 5 more. His master said to them, "Well done, my good and faithful servant, since you were faithful in small matters, I will give you great responsibilities. Come, share your master's joy." Then the one who had received 2 talents also came forward and said, "Master, you gave me 2 talents. See, I have made 2 more. His master said to him, "Well done, my good and faithful servant. Since you were faithful in small matters, I will give you great responsibilities. Come, share your master's joy." Then the one who had received the 1 talent came forward and said, "Master, I knew you were a demanding person, harvesting where you did not plant and gathering where you did not scatter. So out of fear, I went off and buried your talent in the ground. Here it is back." His master said to him in reply, "You wicked, lazy servant. So you knew that I harvest where I did not plant and gather where I did not scatter. Should you not then have put my money in the bank so that I could have got it back with interest on my return? Now then, take the talent from him and give it to the one with 10. For to everyone who has, more will be given, and he will grow rich. But from the one who has not, even that which he has will be taken away. And throw this useless servant into the darkness outside, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated for the homily.
My sisters and brothers, the first comment that we will give is that this gospel reading is a parable. It is a parable which points to a reality, a truth, a saving truth for all of us. It is not supposed to be taken literally. Therefore, what does the word talent mean in the New Testament? The word talent does not refer to the talent of singing, as our beautiful choir does certainly have. It is not a matter of being able to play the guitar, or talent in math, or talent in elocution, and so forth. Talent in art. It refers to a basic currency during the time of Jesus. And at that time, everything was weighed, and it has an equivalence in gold or silver. And therefore, talent was a currency at that time. The currency at that time was called denarius. One talent was equivalent to the wage of a person for 4 days. No? So it is sufficient. And therefore, this man in the parable simply hid his talent. And why did he hide his talent? Because he had a wrong notion, a false impression of his master, as it is said here, looking for harvest where he did not plant and gathering where he did not scatter. In other words, he had a very negative notion of his master. So what does this gospel refer to? As I said, the talents do not refer only to artistic or mathematical or intellectual talents. The talents would refer to the entire gift that God has given to us, our very life. No? Everything that we have is a gift of God. The gift of life, the gift of health, the gift of sight, the gift of clarity of thinking, the gift of faith, the gift of friends, the gift of family. The fact that you're able to come here to worship is a beautiful gift that was generated by God. So everything that flows into our lives is that which the talent refers to in the gospel today. And what could be problematic in our lives is a sense of a lack of appreciativeness, a lack of appreciation for the fantastic and numerous gifts that God has given to us at every minute of our lives. We do have to realize, of course, that every second of our lives, every heartbeat is a sustenance of God. It is a gift of God that we could have ceased at any moment in our lives existing if not for the breath of God that maintains us and holds us and perfects our being. We are here because of the love of God. And yet many times we do lack that sense of appreciation. Saint Teresa of Avila would say that the graces that we receive in life, faith, friendship, family, work, etc., they are like water that runs through our fingers, that we're not able to contain the graces for ourselves. In other words, we waste away the many graces in our lives because of our lack of contemplative awareness. What is contemplative awareness? Contemplative awareness is being aware of God's gift at every moment in our lives. At our waking moments, we realize that everything is God. The fact that I was able to take a cab from Ateneo to here is a grace, no? The fact that a farmer is able to produce grains is a grace. The fact that we are able to walk and come together to worship is a lovely, lovely grace. And yet so many of these graces, we miss out on them. We're not conscious. Hindi tayo mulat na ang dami-dami pala tayong natatanggap. And thus, if we are not aware, if we are not contemplatively aware of the presence of God and the influx, eternal influx of graces coming into our lives, then we become entitled and selfish. That is what happened to this person who received one talent. Because he was not conscious of the fact that there was so much in his life already, he was so selfish that he said, oh, I will just keep these talents to myself. I will just hide them so that when the master returns, I'll just give it back. Oh, yan na. Yan na yung binigay mo. Not knowing that that was something that he was supposed to use for himself and the service of his fellow men. And thus, let us not be selfish. Let us not be dumb. Let us not be sleepy and lazy with the use of the gifts that God has given to us. Being aware that there's so much that we have received. Let us then bless the Lord and say, thank you, Lord, for everything. Without you, I would not have attained and reached this point in life wherever I am now. And we will stop comparing ourselves with others. As the gospel says, each one received according to his ability. Yung angkop lang, yung nararapat lang para sa'yo. But if we begin to compare ourselves with others, ayan na, papasok na ang resentment sa Panginoon. Bakit siya? Merong ganyan. Yan, merong ganyan. Bakit yan? Naging presidente. Bakit yan? Naging CEO. Eh ako naman, marami naman akong sakripisyo dito sa kumpanya na to. No? You know, we become, nagbibilang na eh. Pati ang Diyos, binibilangan na natin. And that's not the point. No? That is entitlement. And that is precisely what the gospel is asking us to let go. If you begin to be entitled, you begin to compare yourself with other people, you will be miserable. Magagalit ka. Maiinis ka. And consequently, you will keep the talent to yourself and you will not flourish. And therefore, shine, my dear Christian friend. Shine with whatever you have. Serve the Lord with gladness. Give it all back to the Lord. Give it back. The more you become selfish, the more you will become little. It's like you're closing your hands like that, and therefore you do not receive grace. But if you open your hands and heart with magnanimity and generosity of heart, you will receive more. Maybe not physically, not financially, but the grace that abounds and surpasses material gifts. And God only knows what those beautiful graces would be upon your life. Let us all rise and profess our faith. Together, let us say, I believe in God, the Father Almighty,
maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who was spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us pray to the Father that we may learn to prepare for his Son's coming by using well our gifts and every good opportunity, so that our lives may yield a rich increase of love for the benefit of His glory and the service of His kingdom. With confidence we pray, Father, listen to our prayer.
Father, listen to our prayer.
May the church, your people, be enlightened and sanctified by your wisdom, so that we may use well our talents and gifts for the building up of your kingdom. We pray.
Father, listen to our prayer.
May political and civil leaders, as well as policemen, use their talents and power to defend the life of the innocent and to render justice to victims of terrorism and violence. We pray.
Father, listen to our prayer.
May all workers here and abroad who are experiencing difficulties and struggles in their work be comforted by the love and care of their loved ones and their community. We pray.
Father, listen to our prayer.
Like the industrious and reliable servants in the gospel, may we appreciate hard and honest work as means to build our lives and our future. We pray.
Father, listen to our prayer.
That those who have departed from this life may eternally enjoy its happiness in the company of the saints in heaven. We pray.
Father, listen to our prayer.
For the prayer intention of our Holy Father Pope Francis for the month of November, we pray for the Holy Father as he fulfills his mission. May he continue to accompany the flock entrusted to him with the help of the Holy Spirit. We pray.
Father, listen to our prayers.
For the Feast Timog, our district builder, feast builders, leaders, and servants, may we strongly unite towards making disciples according to the directions set by our regional builders, aligned with Brother Bo's vision for the feast. We pray.
Father, listen to our prayers.
We also pray for the end of the war in Ukraine and Palestine. We also pray for victims of the recent earthquake in Mindanao, that God may grant them courage and hope, and agencies may be able to assist them. For these we pray to the Lord.
Father, listen to our prayer.
In the silence of our hearts, let us pray for the urgent concerns of our community, those who are in need of our prayers and our personal intentions. We pray.
Father, listen to our prayers.
Grant our petitions, O Father, and strengthen us to live as your faithful servants, ever mindful of your goodness and the gifts to us. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son. Amen.
Amen. Please be seated. We will now have the offering of the bread and wine, symbols of the fruit of our hard and labor of the week. Please join in the singing of the offertory songs.
Please rise. My sisters, my brothers, our table is set. Pray that my sacrifice and yours may become acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Grant, O Lord, we pray, that what we offer in the sight of your majesty may obtain for us the grace of being devoted to you and gain us the prize of everlasting happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that, in your mercy, you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exaltation we acclaim.
Thank you.
Lord, you are holy indeed, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters, our ancestors, our great-grandparents, grandparents, parents, your spouses, relatives, friends, benefactors, all who have gone before us in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus the Christ. For through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus the Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
My sisters, my brothers, the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your
Let's
spirit.
Offer each other a sign of peace. Peace be
peace
with
be
all
with
of
you,
you.
All, my brothers
Happy Sunday.
And sisters.
A blessed morning to all of you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Please all kneel.
Behold the most wondrous gift of God to us, the broken body and the chalice blood of his Son, Jesus. How blessed are we who are called to partake in this sacred banquet.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The body of Christ.
Amen. For orderly.
Act of Spiritual Communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot, at this moment, receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. we have partaken the gifts of this sacred mystery, humbly imploring, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth in charity through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated for some announcements. The feast will continue with a powerful worship and an inspiring talk after the Mass. Please stay with us and be blessed. We would like to invite you to share your surplus on top of your tithes and love offering through SharePlus. Kindly scan the QR code found in the secretarial table. For kids 2 years old to 12 years old, OSEM Kids Ministry is now ready to serve you every second and fourth Sunday of the month, right after the worship, located at the hallway. 2 to 3 years old kids must be accompanied by a guardian. Please look for Kuya Joe Tobias. Thank you. We praise and thank the Lord for sending us Padre Bob Ben Consejo for celebrating the Holy Mass with us. Thank you, Father. Please all sit.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you and your loved ones, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our worship is ended now that love has found us. Let us go and serve the Lord with gladness.
Thanks be to God.
Through the darkest night, the earth is filled with wonder. The trees are shaking from his smile. Name is written in the skies. The God who rules in power, he brings peace to last forever. Who is like our
Magandang umaga. Hi, my name is Brother Japet. Tap the person beside you and say, I am so happy to see you here. Kanina, brothers and sisters, sobrang tuwa ko din pagpasok ko dito kasi ang daming salamin. Ayan sa gilid. Tapos pagtingin kong ganyan, napakomment ako bigla. Sabi ko, hala, mukha akong tatay. And then Brother Benz, katabi ko siya, sabi niya sa akin, hindi ba? Di ba tatay ka na? Oo nga, no? Tatay na pala ako. Tatay na ako. Simula nung taong to, asawa ako. Ngayon, na-promote ako. Asawa na ako, tatay pa ako. That's my lovely wife with her beautiful Dewani over there. Ang daming nangyaring magaganda sa atin sa taon na to. Amen? Pero sinasabi ni Lord, marami pa siyang gagawin sa atin. Are we ready for more? Do we have enough space in our hearts for more? The goodness of the Lord says, there's more for you. There's plenty for you. And today, we will receive as we pray in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Put your hands up. Go, let's sing. Have you seen how good? Have you seen how good?
Jesus.
Shout of praise, everybody! Hallelujah! Are we ready to receive the word of the Lord for us today? Yes? Let's welcome other napakagwapo, napakamatipun na bululok, matipuno! Brother Builder for today, Brother Bimbo Leonardo!
Amen. Good morning, Feasty! Feasty Mog! Buti ko na ba sabi no putin? Amen. God is good, amen? Do you feel it? How good God is? Alam niyo, paano natin makikita how good God is? Tingnan niyo yung katabi niyo. Ayan. That's how good God is because binigyan kayo ng katabi ngayon. Amen? Ayan, tinakwento ni Jape, tatay na daw siya. Di ba ang tagal ng tatay ka? 3 months ago pa. Yeah. Ako tatay na rin. 24 years ago. Amen. Amen. Malala ko yung tatay. Pag yung pari daw, naging lawyer, ano tawag doon sa kanya? Father-in-law. Amen. Speaking of father, yeah, di ba? Tudukts. Amen. Good morning, brother. Pakisabi sa katabi niya, good morning, brother, sister. Amen. Might as well, gato gawin natin. You go around, hug as many people as you can. Come on. Ikot tayo. Tandali lang. Tayo-tayo lang naman dito. Eh, konti lang tayo. Amen. Pakisabi, good morning. Fist bump. Yakap. Yan. High five. Low five. Shoulder hug, mga ganon. Amen. Amen. Ayan, talaga ganon. Okay, let's give a clap offering to worship team. Ayan, meron silang bago ha. First timer, galing. Amen. Amen. As we continue our series titled Plenty, How to Live in God's Radical Generosity. Amen. Sino yung mga nakakumpleto na? Ang third talk na ngayon. Ayan. And title ng, and one big message for today is this. Stop taking, start receiving. Pakisabi nyo ulit. Amen. Baka tinatanong nyo, ano ba difference? Kanina tinatanong ko ni Brother Bong, ano ba difference na nagagalak at natutuwa? Di ba pareho lang yun? So how about taking and receiving? Paano bang, and what's the difference? Tanong nyo, what's the difference, bro? In this talk, brothers and sisters, there's a huge difference. Amen? Nakita nyo, di ba? Na-experience nyo ba to? Pakita natin next picture. Ayan. Sino na naka-witness ng ganyan? Mga batang nag-aagawan. Di ba? Baka kayo mismo nagawa nyo na yan noon. Bata pa kayo, di ba? That's taking, brothers and sisters. That's taking. Para bang laging, yung pag pinag-aawayan, di ba? Parang nakita ko, mas maganda yun eh. Yun ang kukunin ko. Di ba? That's how what taking means. And flash news, brothers and sisters. Makinig kayo dito. Many adults still act like toddlers. Amen. Do you believe that? Yes. Amen. Taking means grabbing, forcing your way, di ba? Yung para bang nakikipagbrasuhan kayo para makuha niyo yung gusto niyo, pushing or stepping on others' foot. Yan ang taking. But why do we do these horrible things? Bakit natin ginagawa 'yon? You want to know why? It's more than anger. It's fear. It's fear. Amen? It comes from the terror that there is a shortage of blessings. Naalala niyo yung mga fast talks natin, di ba? If we have that mindset na kulang lagi, yung scarcity mentality, magiging ruthless tayo eh. Kasi feeling natin you won't have enough. Taking brothers and sisters not only appeared, it not only appearing right now, matagal na ho nangyayari yan, a very long time ago. So are you ready, brothers and sisters? If you're ready, let's pray our first, our favorite prayer here at the feast, in the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Amen. All together, let's pray. Today I receive all of God's love for me. Today I open myself to the unbounded, limitless, overflowing abundance of God's universe. Today I open myself to God's blessings, healing, and miracles. Today I open myself to God's word so that I become more like Jesus every day. Today I proclaim that I'm God's beloved. I'm God's servant. Shout it out. And because I'm blessed, I am blessing the world. In Jesus' name, amen. Come on, let's lift up the word of God.
Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path.
Amen, amen. Brothers and sisters, taking happened in the first fall of man in the book of Genesis. The story says, nabasa na natin to before, and we'll keep reading it, that Eve took its fruit and ate. Took its fruit and ate. Yung sinasabi fruit dito is the from the tree of fruit of knowledge, di ba? You know, brothers and sisters, this act of taking becomes a template that reappears in many Bible stories. Hindi lang sa Genesis, where the author says that person is doing wrong, that something is wrong with that person once the taking happens. You know, in Bible language, taking happens when I do not trust God and force my will instead. Amen? Fast forward natin. Time ni Abraham. Ano ba nangyari? Abraham takes Hagar as a concubine. Asawa niyo na si Sarah. And King David takes Bathsheba and falls into adultery. But we don't even have to go there. Dito lang muna tayo sa Genesis. Just a few chapters after the first fall of man, ito yung nangyari. Another taking happens in the story of the Tower of Babel. Familiar kayo doon? The story of Tower of Babel. The Babel people said this. Let's read this. Come, let's build a great city for ourselves with a tower that reaches into the sky. This will make us famous and keep us from being scattered all over the world. Brothers and sisters, in the New International Version of the Bible, it says that we may have a name for ourselves. Wala naman sinasabing taking dito, diba? Diba? If you read this in your modern eyes, isipin natin, what's wrong with building a high tower, a skyscraper, diba? Kalinga yan, diba? Laking construction yan. What's wrong with that? But if you understand the coded message, brothers and sisters, everything is wrong with that. Kasi kailangan natin, like we were saying before, when you read the Bible, you have to read it with the ancient eyes, hindi yung modern eyes natin. You'll remember that much earlier, God told man to be fruitful and multiply and fill the earth. Yung nasabi ni Lord, fill the earth, multiply. So, God's original call to mankind was to scatter. But now, the people of Babel wanted to prevent that from happening. Diba sabi nila? Because we don't want to be scattered. We want to reach the sky. Horizontal dapat tayo, diba? Scatter instead of going out vertical. Yung ancient readers dito, brothers and sisters, we had to read between the lines. That this was not an ordinary construction. This was a coup d'etat against God. It was a coup d'etat against God. Kasi to the Jews at that time, sky is God's space. God's space yan. So when the story says, let's build a great city for ourselves with a tower that reaches up to the sky, they were not just building a skyscraper. They were planning to take over God's throne. Amen? And here's the truth, brothers and sisters. At the root of every taking is taking over God's throne. It's Adam and Eve's story all over again. So if only the people, if only the people of Babel trusted God, if they only trusted God, He would have given them what they wanted without them grabbing for it. Bibigay naman ni Lord. Because right after the Tower of Babel story, a very different story unfolded. And that's what we're going to discuss today. Amen. Before we start it, let's put our hands in our chest. Let's pray together. Lord God, thank you for your word. Lord God, open our hearts, open our minds, open our hearts with the message that you're going to give us today, Lord. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's live up the word of God.
Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path.
Amen. Let's give a clap of offering to the Lord, brothers and sisters. Bago kayo mo po, pakisabi sa katabi nyo, stop taking, start receiving. Amen. Say amen. In the next story that we're going to take, sabi ko nga, di ba, may susunod yan eh, the Tower of Babel. The next story, there's no taking. Ito, sa next story natin, there's only receiving. Amen? Pakisabi ka, receiving. Pakisabi yung katabi nyo, patingin natin sa katabi nyo, receive ba ng receive lang yan? O nagtetake yan? Di ba? You know, brothers and sisters, Genesis says this. Ito, mas maganda tong kwento na to. Let's read this together. The Lord had said to Abraham, go from your country, your people, and your father's household to the land I will show you. I will make you into a great nation, and I will bless you, and I will make your name great, and you will be a blessing. Amen? Isipin nyo, brothers, eh, no? Kanina, the very people of Tower of Babel, ang gusto nila to reach God para sila maging great. Pero ito naman, kay Abraham, mismo binibigay na ni Lord kay Abraham ang blessing. Hindi niya hinihingi. The very thing that the Babel people wanted to be a great nation and to have their name great, God was giving it now as a gift to a people who trusted Him. Let me say it in another way. Taking is grabbing what you want according to your definition of good and bad apart from God. Yan yung ibig sabihin ng taking. Taking, parang what you want instead of what's good and bad. Dear friend, brothers and sisters, pakinggan nyo to. If you see pain in your own personal life, check nyo yung sarili nyo. Maybe you have been taking. But no, dahil hindi naman lahat ng pain na nararamdaman natin because of some taking. But some are. Baka mamaya, we're just taking. We're not receiving. Today, God is asking you to choose to receive instead. What is receiving from the biblical author's understanding? Let me first tell you what it is not. Yung receiving is not passive. Yung receiving, baka kala natin, naghihintay lang tayo para tumanggap, di ba? It's not being lazy. Alam niyo si Juan Tamad, di ba? Kilala niyo si Juan Tamad? Kapitbahay namin yun. Ito, di ba? Yung picture, ito nakakatuwa kay Juan Tamad, yung legend ni Juan Tamad, di ba? Meron na siya nakikita ang bunga ng, yan, bunga. At nagugutom siya. Pero sa katamaran ni Juan Tamad, ayaw niyang pitasin at nandun lang siya, naghihintay na bumagsak yung bunga sa bibig niya. Yan ang symbolism ni Juan Tamad. Para bang hinihintay na lang. Hindi ho ganun ang receiving. Naghihintay lang tayo sa blessing. Receiving is Working. Pakisabi nga, working. Working with God, yet surrendering the results to Him. That is receiving. Trusting that in the end, He will give you what you need. Amen? Because of our deep trust in the Lord, di tayo nagmamadali. And the result is this, pakibasa nyo. In receiving, you remain faithful, patient, and relaxed because your blessing is coming. Amen? Pakitinay katabi nyo, relax na relax ba yan? Amen? Sabihin, the blessing is coming. He's trusting that the blessing is coming. Amen? Pero ang definition, hindi pa kompleto yon. Hindi pa kompleto yon. When you receive plenty from God, you cannot help but you give plenty too. When you receive plenty, you cannot help but give plenty too. That's why when God told Abraham, I will make you into a great nation, I will bless you, I will make your name great, and you will be a blessing, all peoples on earth will be blessed through you. All people on earth will be blessed through you because you are a blessed person. Amen? So here's a more complete big message for today, brothers and sisters. Kulang yung title natin eh. You stop taking, start receiving, and start giving. Amen? Which is what happened in the last Bible story we'll cover today. Let's read this together. Let's continue the story in Abraham. Let's read this. Lot, who was traveling with Abraham, had also become very wealthy with flocks of sheep and goats, herds of cattle, and many tents. But the land could not support both Abraham and Lot with all their flocks and herds, living so close together. So disputes broke out between the herdsmen of Abraham and Lot. Nag-away-away na sila. Because of the proximity. Magkatabi lang ho kasi sila eh. Yung may property si Lot, may property si Abraham. Dumadami na yung properties nila, they'll be blessed. Pero since they're sharing the land, nagkakagulo na tuloy sila. Amen? Look at this formula, brothers and sisters. Scarcity plus fear equals conflict. You believe that? Scarcity plus fear equals conflict. And that formula, brothers and sisters, is the origin of most fights, most conflicts. Remember what we said before in the previous talk? Naalala niyo yun? In this story, land was scarce. And when something is scarce, ano nangyayari? When something is kulang, it's easier to become selfish. Di ba? It's easier to become selfish. And people will start taking afterwards. Example, ano bang nangyayari ngayon sa China Sea? Di ba? Sa Spratly. Nagkaroon ng conflict eh. Kasi they think they're scarce. Kaya kinukuha nila land yung backup because of the resources there. So nagkakaroon ngayon ng conflicts. Yan ang mga origins of wars, brothers and sisters. If you look at the history, bakit pa nag-aaway? Kasi kailangan namin ng resources eh. Kailangan namin masakop to para makuha namin yung kailangan namin sa kanila so that we could take that. Pero ito yung ginawa ni Abraham. Ito yung nakakatuwa kay Abraham eh. Si Abraham, sinold niya yung family dispute nila by nagkaroon siya ng rules of negotiation. Ito yung nakakatuwa sa rules of negotiation ni Abraham. Di ba? To use niya yung abundance mindset. Abraham gives with the generosity he received from God. So let's continue reading Genesis. Pasahin natin. Finally, Abraham said to Lot, let's not allow this conflict to become between us or our herdsmen. After all, we are close relatives. The whole countryside is open to you. Take your choice of any section of the land you want and we will separate. Continue. And if you want the land to the left, then I'll take the land on the right. If you prefer the land on the right, then I'll go to the left. Baite Abraham, ano? Pero may ikaw na mamili. Para bang ano, naalala ko, bisan yung pagsinabi na may isang pirasong burger, di ba? O hati tayo dyan. O paano nyo hatiin yun? Para equal. Ako ginagawa ko, sige, ikaw maghati, ako mamimili. Di ba? Mautak eh. So gagawin, ang problema nun, nasa naghahati. Kaya kailangan pantay na pantay yan, di ba? Pag hindi pantay yan, syempre lugi siya, pipiliin ko yung marami. Di ba? Pag sinabi ako maghati, o sige, hati na ito tayo. Hatiin ko na lang yan, bahala ka na kung anong gusto mong kunin. Isipin yung brothers and sisters, ano, yung ginawa ni Abraham na yan, parang strategically, that was a lousy move. Lousy move talaga yan. What if Lot chooses the best land? So ano may iiwan kay Abraham, di ba? He will settle para sa mga leftovers na lang. Ganon. Di ba? Pero ito pa yung background dito, ha? Si Abraham, kaya sabi nga, magka-relative talaga sila. Si Abraham was Lot's uncle. Pamangkin ni Abraham si Lot. Si Abraham, siya ang leader ng grupo nila. Biro mo, ako na yung uncle ni Lot, ako pa yung leader niya. Di ba? And in-invite lang naman niya si Lot to join them, eh. Pero, ano ni Abraham, pinapili pa niya si Lot para anong gusto mo dyan, para mawala na yung conflict natin. At that point, brothers and sisters, Abraham didn't take what he thought he deserved. He chose to receive what God wanted to give him. Amen? And that's a symbol of a great leadership, brothers and sisters. Yung parang, huwag mo nang hintayin yung darating sa'yo. Basta bless mo na lang sila at marami blessing na darating sa'yo afterwards. Amen? And here's the key, ha? Even if there was scarcity, Abraham saw abundance. May nakita siyang abundance doon. And the winning formula to save any conflict is this. Ito yung winning formula. Basahin niyo to. Abundance plus trust equals generosity. Abundance, you add that with trust, that's generosity. Siyempre, as expected, ano pipiliin ni Lot? Di ba? He chose the more fertile land. Pero alam niyo, ito ah, magugulat kayo rito. Pinili nga ni Lot yung pinaka-fertile land at nagsettle siya sa isang town doon. Alam niyo pangalan ng town? Ask me what? Sodom. Sodom. Twin sister niya si Gomorrah. So what happened to Sodom and Gomorrah afterwards? Amen? We all knew what happened. Ano pinili ni Abraham? Abraham was left with a second choice. Di pala niya pinili. Kung ano yung naiwan kay Abraham was the second choice. It was the land of Canaan. Canaan. Future Israel. A very fertile land. This is where God defies all logic, brothers and sisters. Isipin niya. God meets Abraham, Abraham's generosity with an even greater generosity. And to, sabi nila sa Genesis, after Lot had gone, the Lord said to Abraham, look as far as you can see in every direction, north, south, east, and west. I am giving all this land as far as you can see. Amen? Para masasabihin niya lang, hanggang saan ang property mo, tumingin ka sa malayo, ano yung nakikita mong dulon-dulo, akin yan. At may sobra pa. Amen? Parang ganon. As far as you can see. And by the way, brothers and sisters, ha, taking and receiving or giving, yung take, receiving, giving, or we call it the radical generosity, cannot be just single actions. Hindi pwedeng isang action lang yan because the universe is governed by the laws of reciprocity. Are you familiar with that? The laws of reciprocity. Kung ano yung binigay mo, babalik sa'yo. Ganun yun eh. In other words, karma. Kung ano yung bibigay mo, babalik sa'yo. That's the laws of reciprocity. Taking and radical generosity, brothers and sisters, became cycles that perpetuate for a very long time. The moment you take, you trigger a cycle of taking. Kasi, kung sino yung kinunan mo, he will also take from you. And mag-aagawa, parang ang bata yan eh. Kukunin mo, aagawin mo. Kukunin mo, aagawin mo. Mga ganon. That's how conflict starts. And that's how conflict starts between families. Diba? Between the family, organizations, kahit yung mga nations. Because of that, that cycle of taking. Kaya nagkakagulo eh. It will be a vicious cycle. And to break the cycle, brothers and sisters, you cannot just do nothing because you have to fight inertia. You have to fight inertia. You must shock the cycle, sabi nga nila. Sabi nga sa Game of Thrones, sino nanood ng Game of Thrones dito? Ayan. Di ba sabi, break the wheel. You have to break the wheel. Ibig sabihin, stop what they were doing and do something for yourself. Break the wheel. Shock the cycle. You must do the very opposite. Do the very opposite. Ang tanong nyo, ano yung opposite, bro? Tanong nyo. Yan. Haba, ano tanong? Start a new cycle of radical generosity. You must start that cycle, brothers and sisters. Ito, side note lang. Sino yung mga married couples dito? Yeah. Sino yung mga young married couples? Ayan, may mga bago tayo mga married couples dito. Ayan. Sige bro, taas lang yan. Alam ko, young ka naman eh. Okay. You know what? You know the secret to longevity of your marriage? Ask me what? Start giving without any expectations. Amen? Without any expectations. Nung kailangan magbigay ng forgiveness, you give forgiveness. You show gratitude. Di ba? Sa mga ginagawa nyo sa isa't isa, kung ano yung ginawa sa iyo, show gratitude. Appreciate everything. Serve each other not only once a day, but twice or even every single moment of possible each day. Kung pwede lang. And that's the secret, brothers and sisters. If you look under the hood of every strong marriages, you'll discover a cycle of radical generosity that has been humming for decades. Amen? Para kami ni Sister Elsa, we've been married for 32 years already. Yeah. I'm always giving. Kasi nasa kanya yung ATM card ko eh. And what she's giving? Pinagsisilbihan. She's serving us. Kami dalawa ni Rhea. Siya yung nagluluto o nag-iisip nung ano yung order sa Grab. Yung mga ganon. Di ba? Nagsiserve siya rin. We serve each other. Lalo na yung nagkasakit ako. Grabe service sa akin ni Sister Elsa. Talaga. Lagi nasa tabi ko yan. Kahit nagpupunta kami sa NKTI, siya pipila doon. Kaya, tatago eh. Thank you, Sister Elsa. Yeah. Yeah. If you're familiar with the love bank, di ba? Love banks. Okay? Mag-deposit na kayo doon araw-araw. You give love and you will receive love. Amen? Deposit to your love bank every day. Kasi ito yan, ha? Pag if your love bank is empty, yung mga cheque, magbabounce yan. Amen? Magbabounce yan. And by the way, ito ha, speaking of banks and checks, listen to this. When it comes to money, ito ha, please do not allow yourselves to be abused. Do not allow yourselves to be abused. You're not loving someone by allowing someone to do that to you. Kasi minsan may mga, di ba, marireceive na lang tayo na mayat maya, nangihiram, kasi may sakit ganito. Okay lang, magbigay kayo kung talagang gusto yung magbigay. Pero don't let him or her abuse you. Kasi minsan baka hindi na totoo. Nangyayari yan, brothers and sisters. Not only in the community, kahit sa families natin. Okay lang. If you want to give, give it all your heart. Pero don't expect something in return. Diba? Don't expect something in return. Kasi pag nag-expect kayo, nababayaran kayo, madi-disappoint lang kayo. But, ito ha, huwag yung allow na aabusuhin kayo because you make him an abuser. Pag kayo inaabuso, siya ang abuser. Hindi, walang iba. Amen? And the community, is discouraging, unwise giving that only breeds parasites. We discourage that. Kung meron talaga bibigyan you, meron tayong LOJ, meron tayong disaster management na tumutulong sa mga nangangailangan ng ating brothers and sisters. Basahin niyo to, unwise giving harms more than it helps. Amen? Wise giving, it builds up. Unwise giving tears down. Kaya always give with love and wisdom. Amen? Palakpakan naman natin si Lord. Amen. Magsilang lang naman yung talk eh. Bahaba kasi announcement natin. Let's all stand up. Amen. I think that's, nabigay na natin yung point natin dito. Start receiving, and start giving. You know, brothers and sisters, in the past, always in the past, kahit ngayon eh, maraming umaatake sa mga preaching natin ng feast. Sinasabi nila, we're preaching prosperity gospel. Marami. Naririnig pa rin natin yan. Actually, brothers and sisters, prosperity gospel means, parang tin-twist yung words ni Lord, but we're speaking the truth here. Mahirap kasi, parang sinasabi, kailangan ba lagi tayo mahirap? Di ba? Bakit kailangan ba lagi tayo mahirap? Kailangan natin something we have to work on. Kaya yung ginagawa ng community, to make you aware that you can make yourself prosperous. Make yourself rich. Alam nyo kasi, once na sinabi na okay lang yung pinanganak kang mahirap eh. Pero kung namatay kang mahirap, kasalanan mo na yun. Yung lagi natin sinasabi nun. Imagine this, brothers and sisters. There's a big Lego set na binigay sa inyo. Pag binigay yan sa isang toddler, what do you think that toddler will do? O magdalawa sila doon? Di ba? Minsan titignan, ano to? Ano gagawin ko dito? O bibuild sila, pero minsan they will fight for a piece. Kasi ito yung kailangan ko eh. Pero ang dami naman palang available doon. Kasi unaan sila, nakita nila, ito. My dear friends, we can really stop taking and we can start receiving and giving. Here are two reasons. First of all, God has supplied a mountain of blessings, raw materials in front of you. Sinupply na ni Lord yan. Gamitin nyo na lang. Yung set of Lego, nandyan na yan sa harapan mo. God has supplied you with your body. God has supplied you with your mind. God has supplied you with talents, with opportunities. And second is this, God has given you the capacity to build anything. Amen? But brothers and sisters, there is a mountain of Lego pieces right in front of you, put there by God. To come with that, He also gave us this magical capacity to build something great, to build something for Him. And let me close this before we come into worship. We're already, napawaw tayo eh, no? This is generosity ni Abraham. Kay Lot, di ba? Wow, galik na talaga, very generous Abraham. You know, but later in the biblical story, there is one who gave everything to his younger siblings. May binigay si Lord sa atin. And that someone was not afraid to give up his divine glory for a human body. His heavenly home for a carpenter's shack. His glorious throne for a smelly manger. He was not afraid to give up everything for you. And that is Jesus. And St. Paul said this, let's read this, for you know the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, that through He was rich, yet for you He became poor, so that you, through His poverty, might become rich. Amen? And the question is this, brothers and sisters, why was Jesus not afraid to give His all for us? Bakit hindi siya natatakot na ibigay ang lahat para sa atin? You know what the answer? He knew He had plenty. He knew He had plenty. He had more than enough. He had more than enough. He won't run out. You know, His life, alam niya, His life was not limited by the grave because God is with Him. The Father is with Him. And today, brothers and sisters, before His cross, I invite you to worship Him. At this core, brothers and sisters, worship is not only giving something to God. It's not just singing songs or praying prayers or offering something to Him. It's not. At its core, worship is receiving His plenty. It's opening our hearts to His abundance. Amen? So are you ready to worship Him, brothers and sisters? If you're ready, let's lift up your arms to Him and let me pray over you. Lord Jesus, I pray over your children that you may grant them abundance in many ways, not only financially, but also in relationships, also in good health, and in many unexpected ways. Open their eyes, Lord, to see how you are already working in their lives. Amen. Amen. Come, brothers and sisters, let's worship Him.
Brought the world to light, and there's nothing that could come to life without you. For you are life and the light, and all will come to see. All of creation will be living for your glory.
Start receiving and worship. Christ.
Brothers and sisters,
hallelujah.
God put dreams in our hearts because we're praying for abundance. Amen. God put it there and He brought resources with Him for you to use. Use your strength. Use your faith. Use your trust in God. Use your body. And because God put the dream there, it will come true. It will bring you abundance. Amen. So if you have your dreams, brothers and sisters, if you wrote it in your Novena to God's love, just live it up. If you don't have the Novena to God's love, just live up your dreams to Him. Lift up your hands. Let's pray for it. Lord God, we thank You for everything that You've given for us, Lord God. Thank You for the dreams that You've given for us, Lord God. Thank You for the provisions that You've given in order for us to fulfill these dreams, Lord God. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Open up heaven's door. We've seen You move with so much more. Let favor and Your presence.
Let's shout it out.
This power in surrendering today, we sing. praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Lift it up. Make a shout of praise to the Lord today. Praise you, oh God. Today we receive. Prepare our hearts, Lord, to receive the fullness of your glory. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen, amen, amen.
Amen. Let's give a biggest clap of faith to the Lord, brothers and sisters. If you're blessed, shout it out. Amen, amen. Amen. Let's all be seated, brothers and sisters. I hope you were blessed by the talk. Yan. Nandito si Brother Japheth. Mag-a-announce ka. Amen. We have some very, just a few announcements before we proceed. Okay. Yeah. SharePlus. Nabanggit kanina to, di ba? SharePlus. We'd like to invite you to share your surplus on top of your tithes and love offering to SharePlus. Yeah, kindly scan na lang yung QR code. Yung SharePlus ang ginagamit natin to maintain this place. Kasi medyo kulang ating konting resources, pero kailangan, we need your help para we spread the good news of God here at Feast Timog sa paligid natin, sa South Triangle, even up till there sa...
Feast Conference! Ayan, lahat ng may tickets na, make a shout of praise to the Lord! O yung wala pang ticket, mas maingay na shout. Ayan, konti na lang. Attention to all, Feast Conference, 2023 New Promise ticket holders. Have you registered already? Classes are now available. Kindly register for your classes at www.feastconference.com. If you don't have a ticket yet, grab your ticket for the most exciting three-day event of the year today. Buy your tickets at www.feastconference.com.
Amen.
Exciting. Yeah,
because the FeastCon is next week.
Oh, konting tulog na lang.
Wala tayo dito next week. No feast next week, but we invite you to attend the grand feast at the FeastCon sa SMX. Doon tayo lahat, buong LOJ, international, everything, lahat ng nandun tayo lahat sa SMX on Sunday for the grand feast. Amen. Sino rito mga wala pa ticket? Ayaw umamin. Sino gusto pumunta sa Grand Feast? Ayan, sinabi ka. Afternoon Grand Feast. Yan. Magpapabigay ako 5 ticket sa Grand Feast afternoon. Yan. Kung sino yung unang 5 pupunta rito sa harapan ko. Yes, nag-iisa lang. Isa lang ang gusto pumunta sa... Ayan, si... Ayan, tatlo. Ayan, apat. Isa na lang, isa na lang. Ayan. Sino tatay mo? Asa na tatay dito? Ayun, ba't hindi tatay? Inuutusan yung anak niyo pumunta dito. Grabe kayo. Sister Nina. Ayan. Oh, si Pio. Anim, oh. Sama na natin si Pio. Kayo ha, siguraduhin yung pupunta kayo. Kasi bibigyan ko kayong ticket. Afternoon session ng SMX. Yeah, kulin nyo kay Sister Elsa nandun. Yun. Okay. Pagkakuha nyo, magmano kayo ha. Sabihin nyo, Merry Christmas. Thank you. Amen. Pero pupunta kayo talaga. Kundi, pabibigay ko sa iba yan. So inviting all women, amen. Sino ba ang babae dito? Kita-kita naman. Come to Jewel's Feast Ortigas Community Event for 2023 entitled Sent. Ayan, parang email lang yan, nakalagay sa Sent. No? It will be on December 9, 10 to 5 p.m. at the Feast Center in Robinson's Galleria. This will be Jewel's event for a cause for the benefit of Jeremiah Foundation. Entrance is free and everyone is welcome. Amen. There will be vendor booths. Pero pala contingent. There will be vendor booths so you can shop for items, wellness talks, praise Zumba. Yeah, may mga sumasakit-sakit ang katawan dahil sa kaso Zumba. And chat time sessions. So register via this. Ano, pasahin nyo na lang yan. bit.ly/jewelset or message the Jewel's FB page. The first 100 registrants get special freebies. Pero hindi dito, doon na lang kayo pumunta. Amen? So, Jules, punta kayo doon. Next one, ayan.
Awesome Kids for kids ages 2 to 12. Awesome Kids Ministry is now ready to serve you every second and fourth Sunday of the month, right after the worship located dito sa ating hallway. 2 to 3-year-old kids must be accompanied by their beautiful guardians. So please look for, eto napakagwapo nito, makikita niyo to kaagad, Kuya Ju Tobias.
Ju, ayan. Tobias.
Pwede bang tumayo si Kuya Ju?
Asa ba si Ju? Nasa, wala namang Awesome Kids ngayon, ha? Tatago. Wala. And we'd like to invite everyone to serve in God's vineyard with us. Amen. Sabi nga ni Father kanina, gabitin nyo ang mga binigay sa inyo ni Lord na talents. If you have the voice, you can play and play, can play musical instruments, join the music ministry. If you have the sweetest smile, yeah, warmth ministry is for you. If you are technically inclined, we have the production team right there. Amen. Yeah. If you are social media savvy, mahilig kayo sa kapopost sa Facebook, join the marketing team. Ayan. We also need photographers, yeah, kasama ni Sister Jack, videographers, graphic artists. If you love children and want to teach them how to love God more, join the Awesome Kids Ministry. Haba naman ito. If you want to pray for others, be a humble servant of the intercessory ministry. We also need servants for the mass, lay ministers, outside servers, butter butler, and for men who care. We invite you to the faculty, facilities, and security ministries. Ito, wala tayo eh. Dance ministry. Naghahanap pa kami yan. We are looking for graceful dancers too. Take note, graceful dancers. Ayan. Kung meron kayo mga ganyan, yung mga binanggit namin, register outside and be blessed. Let us serve with gladness in our hearts. Amen? Gusto yung maging fish builder? Sabihin nyo lang sa akin. Sasalo ko na kayo. Ito, next. Ayan.
Porte ito, man. Mag-ingay. Hey, youth! In the house! Make some noise!
Sino ba mga youth dito?
Yung mga young ones and young at heart.
13 to 24 years old ang youth, okay?
Sabit pa ako, bro.
Pwede ka pa.
24.
Di ka na ako mintutun.
Hang out with us later, every after the feast. Start the week with tawanan, kwentuhan, and more of God's love. See you there. Yeah. Saan yung there?
Here.
See you there.
Mamaya ba may youth tayo? Youth Connect. Ah, pero mamaya, kaya yung mga youth stay here. Meron tayong youth, ano, Youth Connect. So we are excited to launch this year Triple Givers, All Winners, or Sigaw. Ayan. Kung gusto nyo manalo ng inyong mga prizes, Sigaw is our district's annual fundraiser that will benefit Anawim and Jeremiah Foundation and help fund the mission activities of FOD like yung LOX, LLR, youth camps, yung mga ganon. So last year, we were able to raise and give 100,000 each to Anawim and Jeremiah because of the fundraising. Yeah, Sigaw is meant to encourage our families and friends, particularly mga non-feasters, to become our mission partners by extending to them the opportunity to support us by donating at least 200 pesos. This will also give them a chance to win any of the wellness prizes, namely, ayan, 20-inch folding bike. Ayan.
Apple Watch,
tsaka luxury spa for two.
Parang gusto ko, bro, yung ano, spa.
Spa?
Oo, for two. Sa akin, sa kay Baby Dawani.
Ako, yung ako ng Apple Watch eh, baka makain ko yan. 20-inch folding bike na lang. Para gamitin ko pang exercise. Amen. All we have to do is ito, sa inyo lang yung ano, yung Sigaw link natin. Ayan, HT, ayan, yun na lang yung ano, you scan nyo yung QR code, https://paymongol.page/, haba. To our families and friends so they can participate to buy their tickets. Amen. So glad to be ushering the season of giving with Sigaw. Merry Christmas to all.
Calling our power couples.
Grabe, pang siyam pa lang to.
Yan. Kasama pala ako dun, bro.
Kalit.
Your Feast Ortigas District Couples Mission proudly brings you Lux 2024. Lux, or Lighten Up Couples, is for the marriage, is the marriage enrichment program of the Feast Ortigas District. Lux 2024, Lagab Love, is going to be a pre-Valentine's event happening on February 9 to 10, 2024 at the Manresa Retreat House, Banaue, Quezon City. Registration fee is 6,500 pesos only per couple. Per couple na ito. This amount already includes overnight accommodation, food, at lahat ng kailangan nyo nandun na rin. So what are you waiting for? Take your married life to the next level and please make your reservations now.
Amen. Pang Valentine's yan. Yan mga God. Oh, tama-tama. Ikaw na dito.
Ako din to. Singles! Ayun, ready na ba kayo na ma-bless sa Feast Conference? Ready na ba kayo na ma-bless sa Feast Conference? Next week na yon, lahat ba may tickets na, singles? Good news, kasi merong gathering ang FOD Singles Ministry. Yes, Singles Connect sa Feast Con on November 24, Friday. Kape tayo sa Tim Hortons, located at NU MOA Complex, Coralway Street, Pasay City. Konting tumbling lang yun from SMX Convention Center. So there, magagather tayo. Together, let's have a good time at a good place with good people and have good conversations. Together, let's make the perfect blend. It's a Friday. Makikonnect na sa mga singles and see you there. Yeah. Another one, singles. Inviting all of you for our FOD Singles Christmas Party. Masaya to, kaya wag hayaang malamig ang Pasko. Scan the QR code now to register. See you all there.
Yan. Superhero pala yung team niya. Comic Con. Kailan to?
Hapon, after ng feast sessions.
Ah, okay. Sige.
September.
Walang date eh.
December.
Ibigay kayo lang ano, walang date. Ano ba yan? Ayan. Di alam.
December 3, after ng feast yeah. sessions in the afternoon, yeah. it's in Galleria.
Head ng district, singles yan ah. Yan. Ayan. Ito alam ko. Next one. Ayan, you are invited to the Christmas Party 2023 of Feast Timog. Yes, magkakaroon tayo ng Christmas Party. This will be on December 3. Pagbalik natin dito, December 3, immediately after the feast, maglalakad lang tayo ng konti doon kay Popeyes. Popeyes, doon sa Quezon Avenue, nakaharap yun. Malapit lang yan. Yan. Doon tayo pupunta. At December 3, Popeyes Restaurant, 1 to 4 p.m. Para it's time to showcase your creativity and join us in your Christmas attire for a chance to win the Best Dressed Award. Invited ho everyone dito. Okay? Basta magbayad lang kayo 400 pesos. Para doon sa pagkain natin. At the same time, makapag-raise tayo ng fund. Kasi ang plano namin on December 17 after the feast, mag-iikot tayo rito, magbibigay tayo sa mga street dwellers ng Pamasko para sa kanila. Amen? Bibigay tayo. Kaya yung attendance, yung kakain na kayo, baka tulong pa kayo at baka manalo pa kayo ng raffle. Diba? Kaya kailangan natin tumulong din. Brothers and sisters, we receive, we give. Amen? Yun, tapos na ang ating dami. Grabe. May ano who are the first time attendees here? Come on, let's give a raise. Paki-raise nga yung hands nyo. First time attendees. Ayan, meron. Ayan. Could you stand up? Yung mga first time attendees natin? Para to be recognized by everyone here. Ayan. Yeah, let's welcome them. Kung sino yung mga malapit sa kanila, pakisabi, welcome to the Feast Timog. And let's lift up our hands to them. Let's pray over them. Lord God, we thank you for our sisters, our first-time visitors here at the Feast Timog, Lord God. Lord, we bless them. We ask for blessings for them, Lord God. For more abundance, more health, good health, Lord God. Good relationships, Lord God. And Lord, may they find what they're looking for here at Feast Timog, Lord. And Lord, we thank you also for those who invited them. We bless them more so they can invite more. All this we pray in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. Mamaya, we will welcome you. Meron tayong new, first time attend this booth. Will let us welcome you. Amen? Okay. Now, before we go to a love offering, brothers and sisters, pakilabas nga yung inyong love offering envelope. Ayan. Meron tayong love offering envelope. Lahat kayo dapat meron ito. Kundi, may kasalanan yung warmth natin. Dahil wala nang ibibigay ito na lang. Hindi pa maibigay, di ba? Hindi, lahat tayo meron ito. Ayan. Meron dyan sinasabi, Thanksgiving for answered prayers or prayer requests. Susulatan nyo lang yan. And ang dami na akong prayer answered prayers na nangyari sa atin. Ito yung mga iba nangyari dyan. Yeah, thank you, Lord, for allowing PMSI to go back to normal operations school year 2023-24 from Brother June and Georgie Orihana for the 29th wedding anniversary of Brother Roland Toledo for guidance and knowledge for Brother Roland's MA and thesis. Yan, yung mga, thank you, Lord, for being back to our home and again, Feast Timog. Yeah, sino kaya yung anonymous na yan? Manami ko naririnig. Sikat na sikat po si Anonymous, di ba? Thanksgiving for blessings. Passing midterm exam. Success in Project Sector Conference. Give up service kay Brother Austin. Ayan. And thank you, Lord, for all the blessings for family, relative, friends, your love and guidance, provision and protection for the answered prayers. Again, it's Anonymous. And sabi ni Brother Sister Emmy de los Santos, thank you, Lord, for Rhea Ditha's recovery of good health. Many answered prayers have been given granted here at Feast Timog, brothers and sisters. So kung meron kayong mga prayer requests or thanksgiving, just write it here so that we could share it to others also once na the answered name prayers. And before we go into our love offering, let me give you a short story muna. Yeah, short story lang naman to. There was this person na nag-travel siya, na lost siya sa desert. Ang nangyari sa person na to, naubusan na siya ng water. So yung dala-dala niyang flask, ubus na. Hindi pa niya alam kung nasaan siya. At hindi niya alam na napakalaki pa ng desert. But, sa kalalakad niya, at uhaw na tong tao na to, he saw a small shack at the middle of the desert. Ayan. Doon sa pagpasok niya, tuwa siya kasi baka makabero tao doon, matulungan siya, makapagbigay na maiinom. So pagpasok niya, ang unang niyang nakita doon sa gitna ng shack, eto. It's a hand well, hand pump na para magbigay ng tubig. So tuwa siya, nagpunta siya sa gitna, pinapump niya, bakit walang tubig na lumalabas? So pagkatitingin niya sa paligid, may nakita siya isang bote na may lamang punong-puno ng tubig at may takip para hindi mag-evaporate yung tubig. Sa tuwa niya, kukunin na niya, iinumin, pero may nakita siya isang note sa gilid ng bote. Ito yung nakalagay. Use this water to start the pump. Don't forget to fill the bottle when you're done. So uhaw na uhaw ka na. May nakita kang isang bote na may tubig, yung pump, hindi gumagana, walang makuha, pero ang sabi doon, gamitin mo to para ma-pump mo yan, tubig from the hand pump. Kayo, anong gagawin nyo? You're desperate. Kailangan nyong uminom ng tubig. Will you drink the bottle of water? Or susubukan nyo kung totoo yung sinasabi dito. So nagkaroon siya ng, inisip niya na matagal. But he decided, sundin ko nga. So nilagay niya, alam niyo di ba, yung mga poso, di ba? Pinoponduhan niya eh, para talaga lumabas sa tubig. Totoo talaga yon, may mga ganon. So ang ginawa niya, pinonduhan nga niya, at pinump niya yung pump, yung well. And lo and behold, lumabas ang maraming tubig. Lumabas yung tubig. At uminom siya. Tuwan-tuwa siya. Nakapaglagay pa siya sa mga empty flask niya. Sa baon. Nakapagbaon pa siya. And Doon aalis na siya, siyempre nilagay niya yung tubig doon eh. Noon. Instruction kasi, magpunuin mo uli yung bote at iwan mo dyan. Pero may nakita din siya, isa sa corner, may map at may pencil. At nakita niya sa map, ang layo pa pala niya. Alam niyo sa map sa mga mall, bang you are here, parang ganon. Ang layo pa pala niya sa civilization at kailangan niya ng maraming tubig for him to travel. So what if ininom niya yon, hindi rin siya makakapunta sa destination niya. Kaya ang ginawa niya, using the pencil, nagsulat din siya doon sa ilalim ng note at nilagay niya, "Believe me, it works." Amen? You know, brothers and sisters, ano ba lesson sa story na to? Wala, minum lang kayo tubig pag naiuuho kayo. Ganun. We must give before we can receive abundantly. Amen? That's what, yun ang talk natin eh. Start the cycle of generosity, you must give first and then you will receive. Give and you receive. You've been blessed and you bless others. Amen? And there's another message there. Faith plays an important role in giving. Because if you don't have faith, you won't give. If you don't trust God that He will give you your whatever you need, you will not give it. Because you don't believe. You have that scarcity mentality. Have that abundance mentality when you give, brothers and sisters. So hopefully, naisulat nyo na yung mga prayers and thanksgiving nyo dito sa envelope. So let's all stand up. Let's live it up. Let's pray for it. Lord God, we thank you for the many blessings you've given our Lord God. Lord Jesus is a part of the blessings that you've given us, Lord God. We trust you, Lord God. We have faith in you. We believe, Lord God, that we give more, we will receive more. Siksik, luglig, at umaapaw pa. This is for you, Lord God. This is our love offering for you. With our love, with love in our hearts. Take this, Lord God, and let it bless others. In Jesus' name, amen. So with a happy heart, brothers and sisters, let's give back to the Lord.
Have faith, it works. Amen.
Shall be world without end. Amen. In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. See you next Sunday after Feast Conference. God bless you.